The reason I selected Mr. Mizigwich to write about is because he's one of the greatest teachers I've ever had.
When I first met Devin, it was when I had him as a freshman in college, or in high school 3 years ago. And when he first came to me, he kind of set forth, I noticed he wasn't doing much in the room as I was lecturing and talking. And he was listening, he was always paying attention. And I kind of questioned him and I said, you know, Devin, how come you're not doing some of this stuff? And he kind of looked at me and said, because I can't. And for any teacher out there, they don't like to hear that.
If Mr. Mizigwich wasn't there, I probably would have quit school because I was going through a lot of tough things. Or I would have just failed until I dropped out. He encouraged me to come to school because he was there, he was talking to me, he made it something new every day. He made it fun.
So after class, you know, I kind of talked with him and he was telling me of some of the shortcomings he had when learning, and so I kind of just stressed on him that he needs to try.
If you have a problem with learning or something else, he will modify the classes for you and help you in any way he can. He'll stay after school. He will help you on your tests. He will give you extra notes, extra advice about how things work.
And I kept persistent, with him in regards to that, to keep trying. And though maybe in the beginning it wasn't so good, but as time went on that year, he kept trying, and what he was producing was very good work.
He doesn't just care about how you do in school. He cares about you and a person. And I wrote about him because he's helped me with many accomplishments that I have done. He's always pushed me the extra mile to get better in reading, schoolwork, work, everything I do.
I remember him paying attention to nearly every word I said. He rarely took his eyes off me. He was very much into the topic. And he had a very successful year with me, and we developed a nice relationship as the year went on, which has seemed to hold since then.
I used to get picked on about reading disabilities and ADHD, so I used to think everybody was out to get me, that nobody was my friend, nobody was good enough for me, everybody was just an enemy. How he made me care a little bit more is just by talking to me and just being a really good friend and a really good teacher.
It's amazing the development that I've seen in him over the last 3 years, because he came into the room, as I stated earlier, telling me what he can't do, to now, especially when it comes to the mechanics, which is his first love, is mainly his love of what he wants to do for the rest of his life. He doesn't back down from the challenges now.
I've gotten accepted to Johnson College for a diesel mechanic for 2 year school, and I'm really excited about that. He's helped me to push in the right direction. I told him about what I fixed, how I fixed lawnmowers and this and that. He's always like, well, Devin, you should pick up something in that special trait you would really like to do and just do it. You should go and do what you want to do.
He doesn't back down from anything. You know, he went from telling me what he can't do and just completely dismissing it, not even trying, to accepting every challenge that is put forth in front of him. When I first heard that Devin had won this and that I was the teacher that he had wrote the essay about, it's a complete shock. It still amazes me that you can be rewarded for something that you love to do.
What Mr. Mizigwich has basically taught me, if you put your mind to it, you can accomplish anything.